Bliss soldiers, or troops rather, are headed for West Africa today, ready to help combat the spread of Ebola.
ABC 7's Andrew J. Polk was there and is live with the details. Andrew.
Yeah, good afternoon, Denise and Stephanie. Over 100 soldiers said their goodbyes to family and loved ones as the first big group from Fort Bliss loaded up for Liberia this morning. There were tearful farewells as more than 100 soldiers from the 2nd of the 501st General Support Aviation Battalion took off to Monrovia, Liberia. They're joining the advanced troops setting up operations there to begin aiding Ebola treatment units with transportation and logistics.
So the approximately 100 soldiers will be loading onto this airplane for their trip to Africa, stopping in a number of places like Nova Scotia and Spain before finally landing in Liberia.
These soldiers have been trained in support and safety operations, such as how to properly use the protective equipment to keep them from being exposed to the virus, though it's not expected they'll need to use that training.
Well, number one, we'll maintain standoff range. And number two, you know, we're not going to be transporting anyone with who's even suspected of having the Ebola virus disease.
For the families of those being sent to Africa, it's not the same as previous deployments.
It's kind of different than the average Afghanistan-Iraq deployment, since you're fighting a disease rather than another person, so it's a little different.
I'm a nurse, and so I'm very familiar with everything that's going on, and I've been following it, and I believe they have all the appropriate precautions in place, and I'm not worried about him catching anything.
So the soldiers departing today will be part of about 325 soldiers in total in Task Force Iron Knights supporting Operation United Assistance. Their involvement could go on for 9 months or longer. Denise and Stephanie.
All right, Andrew, thank you. And while